the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless this water he has created, which will be sprinkled on us as a memorial of our baptism. May he help us by his grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. Lord God, in your mercy be present to your people's prayers, and for us who recall the wondrous work of our creation and the still greater work of our redemption, graciously bless this water, for you created water to make the fields fruitful and to refresh and cleanse our bodies. You also made water the instrument of your mercy, for through water you freed your people from slavery and quenched their thirst in the desert. Through water the prophets proclaimed the new covenant you were to enter upon with the human race. And last of all, through water which Christ made holy in the Jordan, you have renewed our corrupted nature in the bath of regeneration. Therefore, may this water be for us a memorial of the baptism we have received, and grant that we may share in the gladness of our brothers and sisters who at Easter have received their baptism. Through Christ our Lord, amen. May Almighty God cleanse us of our sins and through the celebration of this Eucharist, make us worthy to share at the table of his kingdom. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. And on earth peace to people of good will. Gloria Jesu in the cielo. Gloria Jesu in the cielo. Y en la tierra paz a los hombres que ame al Señor. We pray. cielo, en la tierra pasan los hombres que ame al Señor.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, constantly accomplish the paschal mystery within us, that those you were pleased to make new in holy baptism may, under your protective care, bear much fruit and come to the joys of life eternal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. As the number of disciples continued to grow, the Hellenists complained against the Hebrews because of their widows were being neglected in the daily distribution. So the 12 called together the community of the disciples and said, "It is not right for us to neglect the word of God to serve at table. Brothers, select from among you 7 reputable men, filled with the Spirit and wisdom, whom we shall appoint to the task, whereas we shall devote ourselves to prayer and to the ministry of the word." The proposal was acceptable to the whole community, so they chose Stephen, a man filled with faith and the Holy Spirit, and also Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas of Antioch, a convert to Judaism. They presented these men to the apostles, who prayed and laid hands on them. The word of God continued to spread, and the numbers of the disciples in Jerusalem increased greatly. Even a large number of priests were become obedient to the faith. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
praises fitting for the upright. Give thanks to the Lord upon the harp. With the 10-string lute, sing his songs. Lord, Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you. For the word of the Lord is faithful, and all his works to be trusted. The Lord loves justice and right, and his merciful love fills the earth. Lord, Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you. Merciful love to rescue their souls from death, to keep them alive in famine. Lord, Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul. Beloved, come to him, a living stone, rejected by human beings, but chosen and precious in the sight of God. And, like living stones, let yourselves be built into a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it says in Scripture, "Behold, I am a living stone in Zion. I am laying a stone in Zion, a cornerstone chosen and precious, and whoever believes in it shall not be put to shame. Therefore, its value is for you who have faith. But for those without faith, the stone that the builders rejected has become a cornerstone, a stone that will make people stumble, and a rock that will make them fall. They stumble by disobeying the word, as it is their destiny. You are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people of its own, so that you may announce the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wondrous light." The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, then you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." Philip said to him, "Master, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us." Jesus said to him, "Have I been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show us the Father'? Do you not believe that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own. The Father who dwells in me is doing his works. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me, or else believe because of the works themselves. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and will do greater ones than these, because I am going to the Father." The Gospel of the Lord. Dear friends in Christ, there are so many different topics that I could preach about today. The ordination of a new deacon in our diocese this week, the 100th anniversary of the apparitions of Our Lady of Fatima, tulip time, the Gospels. But don't worry, I'm not going to talk about tulip time other than to say welcome to all of our out-of-town visitors who have come to enjoy the tulips. So welcome to all of our visitors. But first, I want to briefly highlight the ordination last Tuesday of a transitional deacon for our diocese. And a transitional deacon is one who is preparing for ordination to the priesthood. This is in contrast to permanent deacons who will not continue on to the priesthood. So one young man named Michael Steffes was ordained on Tuesday as a transitional deacon for our diocese in preparation for his ordination to the priesthood, which will take place in 1 year. And every vocation freely and joyfully entered into is a blessing and a gift to the whole church. Deacons, priests, religious sisters and brothers, but also married men and women, which is, of course, the most common vocation to which men and women are called. And our first reading this weekend is very apropos because it is all about the selection and the ordination of the first deacons of the church. It explains why the apostles decided it was necessary to create this ministry of the diaconate. There was a dispute within the church. So even from the very beginning, there have been disputes within the church. And this one, as the reading relates, is between the Greek-speaking Jews who have become Christians, the Hellenists, and the Aramaic-speaking Jews who have become Christians, the Hebrews. And so the Hellenists felt that their widows, who, like all widows at the time, were completely dependent on the goodwill of others because they had no other options, they felt that their widows were being neglected in favor of the Hebrew widows. And so the apostles, unable to dedicate the time necessary for this service, established the ministry of the diaconate. And the word deacon comes from a Greek word which means to serve. So the role of the deacon is one of service to priests, to assist them in their duties, and of especially to service to the lay faithful. And this service encompasses preaching, baptizing, catechizing, works of charity. And for hundreds of years, the permanent diaconate essentially disappeared from the church and was later restored following the Second Vatican Council. So we give thanks to God for the gift of this beautiful vocation and also for the yes that Michael Steffes has made to the Lord to serve his church. And the next thing that I want to highlight is the Feast of Our Lady of Fatima, which we celebrated yesterday. And this year is especially significant because it marks the 100th anniversary of the beginning of the apparitions of Our Lady to three poor young shepherd children. And Mary first appeared to these children, whose names were Lucia, Francisco, and Jacinta, on May 13, 1917, while they were tending their family's flocks of sheep in the fields near a little hamlet named Fatima in Portugal. And Mary appeared to them a total of six times, once a month until October of that year, each time on the 13th of that month, except for in August when she appeared on the 15th, which of course is the Feast of the Assumption. So God the Father chose to send Mary, the mother of his son Jesus, to three poor, illiterate children, ages 7, 8, and 10, to communicate a message of worldwide importance. And Mary gave to these three children a message for the Pope and for all of humanity, which has long intrigued me. If God has such an important message for the world, why didn't he send Mary directly to the Pope, or perhaps one of the cardinals, or perhaps a bishop? But instead, in his wisdom, which is so far beyond our understanding, he sent Mary to these three unknown children living in a poor, forgotten corner of Europe. And there's a lot about the message that Mary communicated to them that is very dark. There's a vision of hell, and there are ominous messages about the spread of communism throughout the world, and about how World War I, which was then raging at the time elsewhere in Europe, and was the worst war that the world had known up to that point, how that war would be followed by another and even worse war within a generation. And there was a secret message for the Pope, which is so serious that it was only made public in the year 2000. But in the end, Mary gave the children a message of hope. She told the children that one day her Immaculate Heart would triumph and that there would be peace. And at its heart, the message of Our Lady of Fatima is a plea for conversion of hearts and of the necessity of prayer and penance for peace and for the conversion of sinners. And the Blessed Mother urged the children to pray very much for the conversion of hearts and for peace, because these two things go together. Every sin is in some way a rejection of God. It's characterized by a lack of love for God and for others, and it produces nothing good. And eventually sin can build up, and if left unchecked, can lead to violence and to war, which are the ultimate rejection of God and of humanity. So conversion of hearts and peace naturally go together. And this is the true message of Fatima. And unfortunately, its message is sometimes hijacked by conspiracy theorists and distorted to focus on its more sensational aspects. But Mary's role is very simple: to be a heavenly mother to all of us, and as our mother, to lead us to her son Jesus. True devotion to Mary should always lead us to Christ. If not, then something is amiss in our devotion. Mary's only desire is to bring us to Jesus. And that brings us to our gospel. Jesus tells us, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." Just as Mary leads us to her son, Jesus is the way to the Father. And he's the only way to the Father, whether we know it or not. And unity with God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit is precisely what we were created for, nothing else. Mary wants to lead us into a deeper relationship with her son, Jesus Christ, and that happens through prayer. That's why she urged the children at Fatima to pray, because when we pray, we grow closer to Jesus. But to say we grow closer to Jesus is such a tepid way of describing what really happens. When we pray, and the more we pray, we fall in love with Jesus. And our love for him, which might be just a dry little seed, suddenly begins to sprout and grow. Perhaps like one of the tulip bulbs lining the streets. See, I'm talking about tulip time after all. Those tulip bulbs just sit in the darkness, underground in the dirt all winter, And then in the spring, with rain and sunshine and warmth, that bulb suddenly begins to respond, and before you know it, a little green shoot pops up, and it grows and eventually produces this beautiful flower. So if that tulip bulb represents our love for Jesus, then the rain, the sunshine, and the warmth represents prayer, which makes our love for Christ begin to grow. And when that happens, as Jesus tells us, whoever believes in me will do the works that I do and will do greater ones than these, because I am going to the Father. Jesus is now, of course, with the Father in heaven. And he's commissioned us to carry on his work here in the world, his work of love and of bringing others to the Father through him. How can we do greater works than him, though? I answer by saying, look at the church. Jesus gathered around him in his lifetime a pretty small group of disciples. Some scholars would say it was probably no more than a few hundred people at most. But after he had ascended into heaven and sent his Holy Spirit upon his disciples, as the Acts of the Apostles tell us, immediately afterwards, hundreds and then thousands more people became Christians. And now the church has spread throughout the world. And the sacrifice of the Mass is being offered constantly on thousands and thousands of altars around the world, all the time. So we are called to continue the work begun by Jesus and continued by his apostles and by Christians throughout the ages. And so let us do so by asking Mary to lead us closer to her Son, praying for the ongoing conversion of our own hearts, for the conversion of the whole world, and for peace. Our Lady of Fatima, pray for us. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Dear friends in Christ, let us pray now for all who struggle with faith or have needs of any kind.
For the church and for all entrusted with spreading the good news to the world, we pray,
Lord,
hear our prayer. For all those places in the world where religion or religious differences cause pain or violence, we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who struggle in their understanding or acceptance of Christ, we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the courage to ask faith questions without belittling or diminishing others, we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For women who have helped shape our faith, for women caring for others in impossible situations, we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those for whom Mother's Day is difficult, those mourning the loss of children or the loss of their mothers, and for those whose mothers cause them pain, we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those among us who are most in need, especially the sick and dying, and for those who have died including Luke Wynn, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious God, we seek to do your work and to make Christ known to others. Give us the courage to live as we are called and help us when our faith falters. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
I will come to you in the silence. I will lift you from all your fear. You will hear my voice. I claim you as my choice. Be still.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands,
O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Cielo y la tierra de tu gloria.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Annunciamus tu muerte, proclamamus tu resurrección, ven Señor Jesús, ven Señor Jesús. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Francis de Sales and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and David our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. And your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
We are many bones. We are all one body, and the kiss we hold. Hallelujah.
as children are not abandoned, for in Christ our sins are pardoned. Alleluia. For in Christ our sins are pardoned. Alleluia. 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 El Señor resucitó. Christ is truly risen, and he walks among the living. To God our glad thanksgiving. Alleluia. To God our glad thanksgiving. Alleluia. 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 El Señor resucitó.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for a couple announcements.
Our annual Mission Trip Egg Roll Sale is taking pre-orders in the gathering space after Mass today. Next Friday, here at St. Francis at 6:30 p.m., is the final movie of our Friday FLIX series, He Named Me Malala. It's a story of a teenage Pakistani activist, Malala Yousafzai, shot by the Taliban in response to her calls for girls to be able to be educated. Be sure and pick up a bulletin for more information on these and other important activities in our parish.
Also, regarding our 2017 Catholic Services Appeal Collection, we are off to a very good start. Last week, we received 130 pledge cards and about $41,000 in pledges and outright gifts. So thank you to everyone who contributed to this. We still need to hear from many more parishioners, so we look forward to receiving your pledges soon. And in your bulletin, you'll find an insert explaining our plans to fund the lighting controls for our sanctuary with our parish CSA rebate this year. Just as we were successful last year in meeting our diocesan assessment and raising the funds needed to repair the bell tower, I'm confident that we can do the same this year for our lighting controls. And also, another announcement, Bishop Walkowiak has informed me that I will be moving to St. Luke's Parish in Allendale on July 1st. So, thank you. So, St. Francis, however, will be getting a new associate pastor, one of our newly ordained priests. He'll be ordained this June 3rd. His name is Kyle Kilpatrick. So, please keep both of us in your prayers. So this is not my goodbye speech yet. I'll still be here a few more weeks. And also, very safe travels to all of our visitors from out of town. Safe travels back home. And happy Mother's Day to all of our mothers. If our mothers could stand, actually, first, Let's have all our mothers stand and we'll recognize them with a round of applause, okay? Now, everybody, please stand. The Lord be with you. Bow down for the blessing. Loving God, as a mother gives life and nourishment to her children, so you watch over your church. Bless these women that they may be strengthened as Christian mothers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth, and grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God.